Hello, my name is Brian Kenyon with my HTT, and in this video I'm going to demonstrate a top-down modeling method with links to the master model. That way, when you update your master model, like shown here, the assembly model will also update. Note that the assembly does not have any assembly constraints, and the component position is based on where it is modeled relative to the work coordinate system. As you can see here, I have different features that will make up the various components in the assembly. I use commands like mirror feature to create duplicates to get a representation of what my full assembly will look like. These features are all separate bodies. If I modify my tabletop sketch, you will notice that features down the line are all updated as the geometry used to create them is tied to the main sketch that sets the overall table size. I could use the new component command. With this command, you can select bodies and it will create a component and add it to your current work part. But when selecting the bodies, feature links are not maintained. Instead, I am going to create a new assembly file. I will then use this assembly file to create a few components that will have bodies that are linked to their respective bodies in the master part. For a better view of what is happening, I am just going to change my window layout to side by side to see both files. Now that I have my new assembly file, I am going to start by wavelinking the datum coordinate system of my master part. I want this because I will use this to mirror or array components based on how I did it in the master part. Note that in order to do this, make context independent must be turned on. This allows you to link bodies that do not reside in your assembly file. With my assembly, my work part, I will start creating new components. These are added to my assembly navigator. Additionally, I want the base to be a subassembly, so I'll create my subassembly model and make that my work part and continue creating more components that will make up the subassembly. As I create these components, please feel free to like and subscribe, and also drop a comment below if you have any questions or ideas that you would like me to explore in my next videos. Now that I have created all the parts needed to make up my assembly, I can now start adding bodies to them that are linked to the respective body in the master part. I will make the tabletop my work part to link the feature. With make context independent still selected, I will then select the respective body. Although I will not link bodies in my subassembly, I will make it my work part to link the datum coordinate system from the master to use it for mirroring my components. From there, I will then make every component in my subassembly my work part and add the respective linked bodies. Note that make context independent is still turned on and I am only selecting the main feature used to create the individual component. Now that I have created all my components, I can now use commands like reflect component to create duplicates of the component. This process mimics what I had done in the master part by using mirror feature. You can also use things like pattern component, but some additional steps are needed, which I will show you later in this video. Now that I have instances of these components, I will now modify my master model to make sure the component's behavior in the assembly is working properly. I'll finish the sketch, and looks like everything's updating as it should. It is also easy to add components to your assembly as your design progresses. I'm going to unsuppress some features in my master model, and you'll notice how if the body changes in my master, the body will also update in my assembly. Similar to before, I will make the assembly my work part to create a new component that will house the link body. Once again, with my new component, my work part, I will use Wave Geometry Linker to link the respective body for that component. Now that I have added my new component, I am once again going to update my master model to see if everything is updating as it should. I'm going to start by updating the table size. And also, I'm going to update my table leg length to a shorter value. Everything still seems to be updating properly. In order to pattern components, some additional steps need to be taken. I am now going to show you these steps. If we look at the master part, I have added a feature array of holes. If we open the dialog box of this array, take note of the pattern definition and that both directions use count and span. Also double check the array vector so that when we array the components, we are doing it in the same direction as the master. Now I'm going to unhide the pins. The feature pattern for the pins just references my hole pattern. I'll do the same in the assembly. Making my assembly my work part, I will now create a component for the pin. I will make that pin my work part and select the respective body. I'm using the base feature in my array. This will be important so that the pattern component works correctly. Using pattern component, note that you cannot reference an existing pattern because that body is linked for that component. Instead, I will use inner part expressions from the master model feature array. Using the same count and span method, I will apply the correct expressions for the inputs. Also, I need to make sure I am selecting the same vector from the master feature array. I will do the exact same thing for direction 2, making sure I'm applying the correct expressions. Also, selecting the correct vector. Then you select the component to be arrayed. And I now have 16 pins in my assembly. Now I will modify my master array to show the behavior of the pattern component in the assembly. As the pattern feature in the master updates, my pattern in the assembly will also update, increasing or decreasing the count using the inner part expressions. And that is how you can create an assembly that is driven by a master part. I want to mention that the make context independent toggle uses the NX Wave license. This license allows for more advanced linking options. Although I may choose the method of using inner part expressions and assembly constraints, this could be a good method for somebody who has modeled all their components in one file and wants to maintain links in an assembly. Once again, my name is Brian Kenyon with MyHTT, and thank you for watching.